Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. Give you some context for this video. My name is Anastasia, I'm 22 years old, and I recently graduated from American University in May. And as you can probably tell by the title of this video, today I'm going to be talking about my experience going to American University and just more broadly going to college in Washington, DC. This is something that I've got a lot of questions about, but also something that I think will be really interesting for you, whether you are looking into American University, you're a prospective student, or maybe you're just curious about DC, life in DC, you're looking to move here. I'm going to break this video up into different sections based on different topics that I thought were relevant when talking about American University and college in general. I just want to give a few disclaimers before I launch into everything. First of all, this experience is entirely my own and no one else's. In no way is it supposed to be reflective of everyone else's experience at AU. I think the beauty of college is that everyone has such drastically different experiences, even within the same university. My second, I guess, disclaimer, if you will, is that this is not all-encompassing by any means. I'm sure there are going to be topics I left out or that I don't go into as much depth about just for the sake of time. But if there's something you still have a question about, leave it in the comments. If there's enough questions that you want me to do a part two video, I could definitely do that, especially with study abroad. I could make an entire video just talking about that experience. So if that's something you're interested in, definitely let me know in the comments. I'm always looking for an excuse to talk about my study abroad experience more. With that being said, let's get into it, my college experience. Starting off with the first topic, academics, my academic experience at AU. I mean, college is overall an academic experience, so had to start with the most important. So I double majored at AU in the School of International Service, where I studied international relations, and in the College of Arts and Sciences, where I did the BS track of economics. Within SAS, just to be as specific with you all as possible, you choose a regional focus as well as a thematic focus area, and you get a primary and a secondary one. So my regional focus was on Europe, and then my thematic focus primary was foreign policy and national security, and then the second one was the global economy. So I really loved double majoring. That was not something that I intended on doing before I came to college. I came in originally as just an international relations major. However, AU allows you to bring over what I would say is a pretty significant amount of AP credits. So I maxed out the number of AP credits I could bring in and got to clear a lot of gen ed classes, which put me a little bit ahead and gave me the opportunity to double major, and I'm really glad that I did. There was an academic advisor that I met with during my second semester freshman year when I decided to go through with this that was really influential for me in the process, and I definitely owe it all to them. Unfortunately, they ended up leaving AU, and I can't say that I had as great of experience with academic advisors at AU after that. I've also heard similar things from my friends, just generally not the best advising. There's a lot of turnover in the advising office, so it's unlikely that you're gonna have a close relationship with one advisor that you develop like over your time at AU. Other than that, I really enjoyed double majoring. I felt like it really helped me to have the more analytical research side of things that was more qualitative, and then have more of the quantitative side of things with econ and the more math related classes. Another part of my academic experience that I wanted to highlight for you all was that I was actually part of something called the Community-Based Research Scholars Program. I didn't apply specifically to that program. I got offered it upon admission to AU. I think that now you can apply specifically to it, but also I know if you apply to AU Honors, and they think you're a better fit for that, then you can get offered a spot into it. So that's how I personally got into it. And it was a living learning community, which means that in addition to having some special classes within this program, you also live on a floor with people in this program. So my floor, my freshman year, was composed of people that were part of the Community-Based Research Scholars and the American University Honors Program. And then I took a few specialized classes, like a specialty in community-based research, as well as a volunteer requirement. I really enjoyed being able to get involved with volunteering in the community. My freshman year, I felt like it definitely gave me a leg up and made me feel more comfortable breaking out of the AU bubble. However, I personally really did not like being part of a living learning community. In my living learning community, as I said, it was solely comprised of people in the community-based research program as well as the honors program, and I felt like it was something that inhibited me from branching out my freshman year, especially the first semester. I think a lot of people made friends with people that were on their floor, and there are definitely some friends that I've made from my floor and my freshman roommate who are still some of my great friends to this day, and I am so thankful for that. So I definitely don't have any regrets. I don't know if I would have been as close with these people if I didn't have that experience, but that being said, I know that it was a common feeling among the group of us that are still friends that it felt a little bit limiting at times. It felt like the people on our floor didn't really branch out as much as we were hoping to, and some of that is just taking the initiative yourself. But also when you're a freshman and everything's new on campus, sometimes you just need to be thrown into those situations. So I don't necessarily know if I could do it all again, if I would do a living learning community, but I wanted to talk about it because I know that AU and also a lot of other universities offer similar programs. So if you're considering it, just take that into account. It really just depends the program that you're a part of, but that was my experience with it all. Overall, I really enjoyed my academic experience at AU. I thought that I got to take a lot of really interesting and really specialized classes that really were suited to my academic interests. And I had a lot of really great professors. I wanted to give a little piece of advice from my time at AU, which is to really take advantage of the opportunities to get close to your professors. If you really like a professor, take advantage of going to their office hours. I know everybody says that, but it's really true. It can make all the difference. Talk to them about your career goals, talk to them about your concerns about the class, and it's really great to have professors who understand your goals and are on your side, because down the line, if you need a recommendation for something, they're always there for you, but also they oftentimes loop you into opportunities that you wouldn't have heard about otherwise, be it internships, job postings, research positions. And also you can just find a really good mentor. I've had a few professors over my time at AU that I've been really close with, and it's just good to know that you have someone that's advocating for you. The next topic that I want to talk about is campus involvement and social life. So I was involved in a variety of things over my time at AU. Something that I got involved in during my freshman year and was a part of all 4 years was a student-run dance club called AU in Motion. It's where students choreograph and perform pieces for other students as part of an annual showcase. I really enjoyed it. It was a great smaller community within AU, and it definitely introduced me to a lot of people that I wouldn't have met otherwise. I personally didn't have the time to take on like a dance major or a dance minor, but it was a great way to continue my interests. For reference, I was on the dance team in high school, and I've done dance, ballet, hip hop, contemporary my entire life. Well, I think that a lot of people struggle to find communities within college, and the number one way to do that is to get involved. And I know you're probably thinking, how do you hear about these clubs or different things to become a part of? There is always an activities fair. Try to go to that if you can. And if not, just ask around. Ask your RA, ask your TAs in class, or just classmates of yours. Bridging the community involvement and social life aspect, I was involved in Greek life during my time at AU. I joined Delta Gamma my second semester freshman year. That's when there was rush at American University. I joined DG, and I was an active member until the summer before my senior year, when I ultimately disaffiliated. I joined my freshman year as a way to meet more people. As I said, being part of that living learning community, I felt very limited, and I felt like I wanted to branch out and meet a lot of different people on campus that I wouldn't have met otherwise. And it definitely served its purpose in that aspect. I met a lot of great people, a lot of whom are some of my closest friends to this day. I will definitely share some articles down below about kind of the campus climate, and a lot of information came out last summer about individuals' experiences with racism as well as assault and harassment on AU's campus. And the overwhelming majority of individuals or groups that were implicated in those were Greek organizations. And as a result of that, myself and the rest of my chapter had a lot of really intensive discussions about what we wanted out of this organization, what reforms we wanted to make. We talked to nationals about it, and ultimately at the end of all of those discussions, I didn't feel comfortable remaining a part of the organization. I felt like the changes that I would like to see to remain part of it just weren't possible. While I did have a mostly positive experience in Greek life, I also am a white woman, and the system was created with me in mind. A lot of barriers for other people that I did not have as a member of Greek life, and so I acknowledge that. There are a lot of flaws that are built into the system that just can't be undone by simple reforms. And so in the end, I and many people that I consider dear friends decided to leave the chapter. That is basically the quick summary of my experience with Greek life at AU. I would say that when I was in it, it was a big part of my social life, especially in the beginning when it was just all new and exciting. And it definitely helped me to meet a lot of people, but also there are so many people who aren't a part of Greek life. I have so many great friends that I met through the other organizations and situations that I've been involved in through my study abroad program, and you absolutely do not need Greek life to make friends at American University. I'm sure if you're watching this as a prospective student, you're probably wondering about the party scene at AU, and I will say it's not a big party school, like a big state school or anything like that. There aren't really any campus bars. I would say AU has more of a nightclub type culture. People go out in DuPont Circle a lot and Adams Morgan, different than your experience in a small town college that has specialized college bars. You're kind of just going out at different places in the city where other people in Washington would go out anyways. Moving into a topic that's kind of related to that, just the overall campus culture. AU is definitely very unique. It is very different, as I've said, from a state school. It doesn't really have any sort of school pride. In fact, there's kind of a common ground among students bonding over not having school pride. I liked AU, I would say overall. I had a really positive experience, and I can't see my college experience being any different now that I've gone through it, but it definitely takes some time to adjust to it, especially if you are someone who went to high school where most of your friends from home went to big state schools that had a lot of school pride. I'm from Ohio. A lot of people I knew went to Ohio State, OU, Miami, where people have a lot of school spirit. So it was definitely really weird for me, and I definitely had a little bit of an identity crisis with it all because I did want to have pride in my school. I even considered transferring out of AU at one point just because I felt like I wasn't getting the full college experience, but it's just a different college experience. It's not a town that revolves around your college experience. It's not football games and a ton of school pride, but it's still a very valid college experience and one that can be really fun if you take advantage of the opportunities that are given to you. Which leads me into our next topic of my professional development at AU. I think AU does a great job of preparing you for the workforce and post-grad life. It's definitely something that can be a little bit intense to step into, and it's very different from other colleges. I think it's something that's unique to going to school in a city. There is a big internship culture. It is very normal for people to intern while taking a full course load, and I tell this to my friends who don't go to school in DC, and they are so confused by it because it's crazy. It's very hard to manage, and I don't think that you should put that kind of pressure on yourself. I took a full course load and interned one semester, and I was very overwhelmed by it, I have to be honest. But AU is just a very career-focused school. They provide you a lot of resources, and you're surrounded by people that are always networking and, you know, looking for the next move in their career. So it really pushes you to think about those things in your personal life. So just wanted to give some advice from my experience. I would say that at AU, you should really take advantage of the Career Center resources. There are people who are willing to review your resume for you. There are people who you can meet with one-on-one career advisors within your individual school that can give you advice if you talk to them about your interests. Also, those professors that I talked about networking with and forming connections with are such invaluable resources. Your peers as well. Personal connections really mean the world when it comes to networking. Be personable, keep up with people, be genuine. Reach out to them because you actually care. Don't only reach out to people when you need something from them, and you'll go far. And now to discuss my favorite thing to talk about, study abroad. Please give me between 10 and 25 seconds to just insert a quick montage of abroad here, if that's okay. As I said at the beginning of this video, if you want me to talk more about my abroad experience in depth, I would be happy to film a separate video for it. But for now, I'm gonna just give you a basic overview. I studied abroad the fall of my junior year in Copenhagen, Denmark with the DIS abroad program. I really enjoyed it. You weren't a student at a Danish university. It was a specific abroad institution, which was a little bit different. So all of my classmates were fellow Americans for the most part. They came from all different schools across the US. So it was really fun because in addition to meeting local Danes, I also got to meet a lot of different American students. And I do wish that I connected a bit more with the Danes. I had a visiting host mom, which means I didn't live with her, but I got to meet with her several times throughout my abroad experience and just talk about Copenhagen, her experience living there, and just have someone that I could bond with. I definitely would say if you are going to a program like DIS, take advantage of all the opportunities to meet with Danes. There are certain things called collegiums, which are places where you can live with local Danish university students, which I think is really cool. And the people that I know that did that loved it. So definitely would recommend if you go to that program. I lived in a residential community, lived with only other students from DIS, and I really enjoyed it. I had some really good friends through that community, and I absolutely loved the DIS study abroad program. I would recommend it to anyone. Honestly, I think I'm biased, but I think it is the best out there. You get a lot of really good experiences. You get a lot of time to travel both with your classes and have specialized travel that is related to your areas of study and on your own, as well as just the opportunity to really explore Denmark. On Wednesdays, you had field study days, so you didn't have classes, but your classes that you had on the other days could schedule field studies where you would go out to different locations in Denmark and explore things that were related to class or talk to people that were related to class. And I absolutely loved that experiential learning component. That is my very quick spiel about my abroad program. More generally, going abroad at AU is very common. I would say that the majority of my friends went abroad. AU has a wonderful abroad office and they really work on making it as accessible as possible. I was able to transfer 100% of my scholarships from AU over to my abroad program, which made it so that it was not more expensive than a semester at AU. And for a lot of programs, it can actually be cheaper than a semester at AU, which is awesome. Pretty split at AU what semester people study abroad. I went in the fall. I think there were slightly more people that I knew that went in the spring, but I know at some other schools, like, everybody goes in the fall or everybody goes in the spring, but it's pretty split at AU, and especially with COVID, there's been a lot more people who are going abroad senior year too. So I would highly recommend it, especially if you're in an area of study that relates to the international economy or international politics, etc. But even if you're not, there's a program for everyone. So I really encourage you to do it if it is possible for you. If you're going to AU, definitely talk with the study abroad office. They will do everything possible to make it possible for you. And last but not least, I want to talk about housing. I'm saving this for last because it's really specific to people who are interested in AU. So if you're not interested, you can exit out. But here is my experience with housing. As I said, I lived in a living learning community my freshman year. I lived in Anderson Hall. That's like one of the main dorms. There's three dorms, Anderson, Centennial, and Lutz, that are all basically connected. There's just different sides of the building. I lucked out. I lived on a newly like renovated side. It was a dorm. It was a freshman dorm, you know. It was small. It was not the cleanest. There were communal bathrooms. But it was a good experience, all things considered. In my sophomore year, I lived in one of the East Campus dorms in a double, and it was really nice. It was very new. We had our own private bathroom, which was a nice step up from freshman year. Honestly, if I could do it all over again, I think I would have tried to go for Cassell sophomore year, which is like a suite style, or gone off campus into an apartment, but I don't think I was ready to move off campus into an apartment yet. It's really big at AU that a lot of people move off after their freshman year, which is a lot different from other schools. My junior year in the fall, I went abroad, as I already talked about, and I had a random roommate. My program made you fill out a survey and then they just randomly assigned you a roommate. I don't even know if you could request one, but they didn't usually have you living with someone from your school. So I roomed with a wonderful roommate, Megana. If you're watching this, hello, you were the best. And we lived in a double with our own bathroom. And yeah, my roommate Megana went to Duke University, which was really cool because I got to learn a lot about Duke campus life and just like the differences between Duke and American. So it's not all bad when you get a random roommate. We got along great and I so appreciate having had that experience. And then my senior year, I lived in a house with four other girls in Tenley Town and I loved it. It was great. It was super convenient. Again, I wasn't going to campus, so I can't really speak to that because it was all virtual, but I loved being really close to the metro and being close to the town location. And yeah, I would say that I mostly lucked out with pretty good housing experiences during my time at AU. So that just about covers my AU experience, condensed into a tiny little YouTube video. Well, not so tiny, it's probably gonna be kind of long, but I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you're looking at AU or if you're just starting at AU, I hope you love it like I did. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask them in the comments, and I'm happy to film a follow-up or to answer them for you all. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you're subscribed, give it a like, and stay tuned for many more videos about my life in DC, transitioning from college to postgrad, as well as fashion, beauty, and lifestyle videos. Thank you. I'll see you all next week. Bye.